Hello everyone and welcome to the Pencil Tutors channel. I'm Servina and today I will be teaching the topic of momentum. This is Part 4 Physics Chapter 2.5, so without further ado, let's get started. First off, what is momentum? Momentum can be defined as the quantity of motion of a moving body measured as a product of its mass and velocity. Momentum is a vector quantity and it moves and has the same direction of the object's velocity. The formula for momentum is P is equals to mv, and this symbol right here is the symbol for momentum. Now, don't be confused with inertia. Momentum is a quantity that is affected by both the object's mass and velocity. Therefore, let's say if we have two objects right here, one which has a bigger mass than the other, the object with the bigger mass would still have the biggest momentum compared to the other one. However, if we change it up a bit and change the velocity of the smaller object, we would actually get a higher momentum despite having a smaller mass. That is because, as I said, momentum is affected by both the mass and velocity of the object. You could also kind of see momentum as a quantity to determine how hard it is to stop an object in motion. It will be harder to stop a heavier and faster object, right? The SI unit for momentum would be kg meter per second. A very, very important principle in momentum is the principle of conservation of momentum. The principle states that the total momentum of a system is constant if no external force acts on the system. An example of external force is friction. However, this principle is only true if the system that we are talking about is a closed system. Now, what exactly is a closed system? A closed system is a system in which the total external force acting on the system is equals to zero, which means that the system must have no friction applied to it, or if there is a friction, there has to be another external force in the opposite motion to counteract it. This principle is applied to two situations, collision and explosion, and we will discuss about those two situations next. Let's talk about collision. Now, there are two types of collision. First off, we have elastic collision and inelastic collision. For elastic collisions, the objects would collide and then move apart, either in the same direction or in a different direction. It doesn't matter if the objects move in the same direction or in a different direction. What's important is that the two objects move apart. For inelastic collisions, however, the objects would collide and then it would move together with the same common velocity. The keyword for inelastic collisions is that the objects move together and they would have the same common velocity after the collision. An important thing to know about collision is that the total momentum before the collision will be equal to the total momentum after the collision if there is no external force acting on it. Based on this, I will write down the general formula for each of the collision so that you guys would see and understand it better. So the total momentum of the collision before would be the sum of momentum of the two objects. So for the momentum of the first object, we would have the mass of the first object multiplied by the initial velocity of the first object, added with the mass of the second object multiplied by the initial velocity of the second object. That would be the before part. And for the after the collision, it would be almost similar. However, we would change, instead of initial velocity, we would have the final velocity. So this would be for the after part for an elastic collision. For an inelastic collision, it would be a bit different. First off, we would have the momentum for the first object, which is the mass multiplied by the initial velocity, added with the momentum of the second object, which is the mass of the second object multiplied by the initial velocity of the second object. However, for the after portion, as we all know, inelastic collision, the objects move together and they will have the same common velocity. So we could rearrange the equation and we would get something like this. There's no need for us to kind of separate the two momentum. Just like in elastic, there's no need for us to do that in inelastic because, as we all know, they have the same common velocity, so we can just simplify the equation to something like that. Now, I want you guys to memorize these two general formula and use them accordingly according to the question. Now, let's talk about an explosion. An explosion is when the system is stationary at first and then the explosion happens where the two objects in the system would move in opposite direction. For example, let's imagine that we are firing a gun. At first, the gun and bullet is stationary, just like shown here. And then after we pull the trigger, the bullet will move forward at a certain velocity, just like right here, and the gun would recoil backwards. And that is what we call an explosion in physics. Based on the principle of conservation of momentum, the total momentum in the system must be constant. So the, you know, just like in collision, the total momentum before must be equals to the total momentum after. And since before the explosion happens, the two objects are stationary, therefore the total momentum before is equal to zero. And the total momentum afterwards must also be equal to this. And if we actually rearrange this equation, we would get that the total momentum of the first object and the second object is actually the same. It's just that the total momentum for the second object would act in the opposite direction. Therefore, that is why we have the negative sign right here. Now, the general equation for an explosion that you have to write if the question is talking about explosion is this one. Please memorize this equation. Let's answer a question together. The diagram shows a squid being hunted by a shark. When the squid realizes it is in danger, it will eject a stream of black ink to hide itself and propel away to escape from the shark. First question asks, draw the direction of the ink ejected by the squid and label V1 and direction on the recoil on the squid V2. There's a few keywords here that you must take note of that shows what this question is about. Firstly, we have the word eject and the word recoil, which shows that this question is an example of explosion. And the question has also given us a hint on the direction of the squid. Since it propels away, therefore, the direction of the squid would be in this direction, and that would be V2. And the direction of the ink ejected must be in the opposite motion, since this is explosion, and it would be in this direction, and that would be V1. The physics principle involved in this is the principle of conservation of momentum, which explosion is one of the examples for that principle. The next question has given us a calculation situation. If the squid has a mass of 250 gram and ejects 10 gram of black ink with a velocity of 60 meters per second, calculate the recoil velocity on the squid that helps it to escape. First things first, we're going to label the objects to correspond with the velocity that we have already labeled right here. Therefore, object number one would be the ink, and object number two would be the squid. And I've already written out all of the information here, here, and here. Now, we're going to write out the general formula for explosion, which is this. And now, we are looking for the recoil velocity, which is the V2. And I've already set the direction towards the right as the positive direction. And now we're going to rearrange the formula to put V2 as the subject. And then when we substitute all of the values that we have inside, we will get that the velocity is negative 2.4 kilogram meter per second. Note the negative value here That actually means that the velocity of the recoil squid is on the opposite direction as the velocity of the black ink. Next question asks, give one example of an application of the principle stated in 3B in transportation. An example of an application of the principle of conservation of momentum in transportation is actually rockets, which is an example of explosion. This is because initially, before the rocket is launched, the rocket is stationary and at rest. However, after it is launched, the rocket would move upwards and there will be hot gases moving downwards. This is a perfect example of explosion because initially the system is at rest or stationary and because the two objects are moving in opposite motion. The next question is a calculation question and it says that diagram 3 shows trolley P of mass 1.1 kg moving to the right with a velocity of 15 meters per second collides head on with a trolley Q of mass 1.0 kg which is initially at rest. The two trolleys stuck together after the collision. So since it is stuck together, we know that this is an inelastic equation. Now I'm just gonna write down the trolley P as the first object, so that'd be 1.1 kg and velocity of the first object is 15 meters per second, sorry, initial velocity. And the second object has a 1.0 kg and its initial velocity is 0 because it is initially at rest. And it is asking us to find the velocity of the trolleys after the collision. Since it is stuck together, they will have the same velocity. So I'm just going to write down the formula for an inelastic collision, which is m1u1 m2u2 equals to m1 plus m2v. And we are looking for the v right here. So you can just rearrange the formula in order to put the final velocity. Sorry, this is u. as the subject. And then once we put in all of the detail that I've already written out right here, just substitute all of it in. And when we calculate that, the answer would be 7.86 meter per second, since this is talking about the velocity. So the answer would be D. Alright, that is all from me today. Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you guys learned something today. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Just to let you guys know, we upload videos every Monday, Wednesday and Friday covering the subjects of physics, mathematics and biology. That is all from me. Thank you so much and see you guys around.